Alright, Lions, so 1,000-year Blood War Round 6 Resurrections are finally here. Let's check them out. Today, we're going to be showcasing one of my favorite characters in the game. Or at least at a time when she first released, she was one of my favorites. We have Nemu, and we also have a Max Transcendent, because at the time, she was one of the best characters in the game. And I was very fortunate enough to get a 5 out of 5, and that's why she ended up being one of my first Max Transcendable characters. So as already mentioned, when she did release back in 2016, she was one of the better characters in the game. And when it comes to the strong attack kit, which you're going to see in this gameplay, she's aged quite well. The only thing that she's really lacking in nowadays compared to some of the newer characters is damage output and also survivability. Lucky for her though, this resurrection changes that a bit and makes her a tad bit better in the survivability aspect and most importantly the damage aspect. So first up, when it comes to a resurrection upgrade, if we have a look at the soul trait, she is a 12% recharge soul trait now with the addition of doing 16% more damage to enemies not afflicted by an ailment. It's the first time we've seen a soul trait like this, and I like to think it's pretty good. As of right now, though, there's only really two characters that can benefit from this link, that being Chad and also Yumachika, and it is a very situational soul trait. You don't want to put this on someone that is constantly inflicting status ailments, like 8th anniversary Ichigo, for example. But nonetheless, I do like Caleb experimenting with these resurrections. It's a good link for herself, and if we ever get more characters in the future that do also want to do more damage to enemies not afflicted by an ailment, potentially this upcoming end of month, who knows, then this is going to be a must-have link for that particular character. When it comes to her skills, for starters, she picked up an additional 100% last-ditch survival with the innate skill, which kind of goes well with the fact that her soul bomb also can potentially revive you. And this is important because she also did pick up 40% more damage at low stamina, which I guess also makes sense. Keep in mind though, she also did get a 10% increase on her Berserker value, so now she has a 30% Berserker built in, which I think is kind of cool. So overall, with this upgrade, she got around like a 70% damage increase when at low stamina, right? And also got the last survival, which makes sense because she kind of wants to be at low stamina. At low stamina, you are playing the risk of getting potentially one-shotted, and you won't have to worry about that thanks to the fact that she was actually given last survival. I kind of like the idea of the resurrection. We don't really experiment much with low stamina damage builds. Like, I'm not sure when was the last time I've ever done that, but I wouldn't mind more low stam damage characters coming out in the future, and maybe this Nemu is a precursor to that. 99% of the time we're going with full stamina damage, so it would be nice if we potentially change things, and Nemu is one of those characters. So with that said, let's jump into some content and try her out. And by the way, this is the build. 4-pill, T-set, Lieutenant's Badge, with just recharge and also strong attack damage. Bonus abilities include low stam and also long stride. Alright then, so first up, let's take it into single player IT. Let's see if we potentially can get to low stamina. I guess that's the unfortunate thing. Maybe I want to remove the level 10 stamina. Because again, we do have a Max Transcendent, right? We have to... This has always been the unfortunate thing about low stamina damage builds, and we have to kind of have to waste time to get low stamina, and now we can start doing our damage where we are one-shotting, to be fair. That's not too bad. I know we are in single player IT and we do have a Max Transcendent, but I'm liking it thus far because we are at natural disadvantage here since we can't inflict any status ailments. We really are relying on our damage output. There's an example of why that last disavow was actually really good for Nemu, since we did get attacked by that one mob that hits like ridiculously fast. Let's use the soul bomb there, and that unfortunately did put us down, but we got back up because we had the last ditch. Let's use our SO2 there. That's not too bad. That felt quite smooth, to be honest. I mean, maybe I'll use my strong attacks until the mob with the hat shows up, because he pretty much one-shots you. For our very first run, we'll take it. It was a one-minute run, but most of that time was waiting around to get at low stamina. So let's kill these enemies here. Can see a definite note, a big difference when we're not at low stamina. Let's just let this guy attack us, because he can get us down to low stamina quite fast. There we go. I never even knew he had a different attack other than that kick. That's kind of funny. And he took us out again. Okay. Maybe this run is faster, though. We'll see how it does go. So we did lose the last ditch, but remember, we also do have the soul bomb, which can also potentially, you know, give us that extra survive effect, revive effect for the most part. Let's go ahead, use our SA3. Looks like I'm doing around 7k damage per hit, which is not too bad. Remember, we are naturally doing 80% less damage since the enemies do have iron skin, but it's not stopping us, to be fair. Let's once more use our soul bomb there, and now we're into Tsukushima, where we can finish up using one strong attack. I'm liking it. It's still awkward, as always, trying to get to low stamina, but we aren't doing too bad. I'd like to see what the clear time looks like if we could... I would really like if a character could spawn in at low stamina, because then we don't have to waste time, because 52 seconds is kind of on par with what you expect of a character like this, but she realistically would be getting maybe a 40-second clear time if we didn't have to waste all that extra time trying to get to low stamina. But if we possibly can, let's shout out one more time. This time we're gonna try and let's do this. Okay, then we can potentially get low stamina real quick here. There we go. Maybe spend less time here. Let's use our SA3 there. That's not too bad. SA1 on these lads. And then back up with the SA2. Finish up with the SA1. I'm going to use my Soul Bomb here. No idea if this is the best strategy, but let's do it. Since we are waiting for our strong attacks to come back. Luckily, did actually clean up that wave. SA2 in this map is actually really good. Yeah, this might be our fastest run yet. That felt really good. And then hopefully one strong attack is enough to put down Tsukushima. Okay. And we've already mentioned it, but this Nemu does have a good strong attack kit. Like, this kit still holds up relatively well. And that's more likely, to be fair. 37 seconds. I would like to think that would be a sub 30 if we didn't have to waste time getting here. So honestly, not too bad. But now let's put it to the real test, taking it in to a Cobb IT, which by all purposes, she should not be good here, right? They have killer against us, we don't have killer against them, and we also, most importantly, can't inflict any status ailments. So we are kind of brute forcing it here with our damage output, and being at low stamina definitely does help it just a tad bit. But we can see for the most part, we are clearing a tad bit slower compared to at least single player, right? But it's not too bad. I think the bosses are going to be the more annoying part here because it is a very linear room, right? So beams like our SA2 really work well here, but it's also bad against boss stages when they also have really good linear attacks. Already into the third stage against the bosses. We got to make sure we have some strong attacks ready for when they do spawn in. Because yeah, it's going to be a bit brutal. If we had killer, keep in mind she has holo killer, by the way, might be a bit more usable in terms of clear time too, right? So let's use our SA3 here and then SA2 onto that. There we go. Bosses have spawned in. To be fair, the bosses ain't too much of a struggle, to be fair. We're doing like 30k to them. Well, I guess in this case, they don't have iron skin, so it makes sense. So you can kind of see what our damage output would look like if the enemies didn't have iron skin, and it looks like we're doing around 30k here. I mean, thus far, so good, to be honest. I know we aren't clearing the fastest here, but we haven't gotten hit yet, and that's one thing I'd like to commend about her, and it mainly comes down to a strong attack hit. It's like, sure, we're clearing slow, but I'm not constantly getting hit and dying, you know? I'm able to get in and out of combat super quick. Let's back up here. That's many thanks to the long stride, though. And then SA3 on this lad. Yukio goes down. And now we're into the final stage. We do have a 5 out of 5, so our Soul is hitting harder, but I have no idea how much damage that's going to do. Unfortunately, I got paralyzed, but good example of that last survival. Let's use our Soul now. Does it nuke? It does. SA2 on that. SA1 there. Did we take out the Tsukushima? We did not. We have one more strong attack to go, though. And there we go. Definitely on the slower side, but I will say I didn't have any problems dying there. The only time I actually got knocked out and actually died there was when I got accidentally paralyzed. That was my fault. But that's where the resurrection comes in handy. We had that extra 100% last stitch, and that definitely did help us there. So I kind of like that. The resurrection itself makes sense. She wants to be at low stamina, and to have that extra bit of security, they also gave her the last stitch, which I do like. And I think that's a good example of why that is a good skill that she did pick up. A 3-minute clear time isn't anything super exceptional. It's definitely on the slower side. But usually when I do try out resurrected characters, sometimes we potentially die. I mean, Yamamoto, for example, he was able to clear quite fast. He had the increased chance to inflict status ailments. He had the killer effect. But I also noticed that I was kind of getting hit a lot more often. In Nemu's case, we really didn't have much of a problem. That comes down to a strong attack kit. It's still good to this day. The only thing that's holding her back compared to some of the newer characters is the damage output. But she regardless still did get a pretty big damage increase. Next up, though, we're going to take it into the Mairi Epic Raids, where we get to test out our damage output, see how fast she can do around 15 million damage, if she possibly can. In this case, when it comes to the pets, we've given her these, so we are getting that extra 60% low stamina damage. Unfortunately, don't have really the best set of pets for her. You know, ideally, you would want to rock the Kenpachi and also Toshiro pets with also low stamina, but I don't really do that many low stamina builds, so I've never actually prepared for that, but at least I still have these pets, so we are getting that extra 60% damage output. These are the accessories. And then these are the links, just going with a bit of recharge, strong attack damage. And this Noritora is going to be one of our better links, giving us 24% low stamina and also 20% more strong attack damage. Again, once more, low stam damage builds don't really have much to work off here. When it comes to the power attribute, that's the only link that she can use with strong attack damage and low stamina. So if Caleb do plan to potentially make low stamina a bit more common than it has been at least the last, you know, 4 or so years, I would like to see some characters pick up low stam as a soul trait. Because I'm not going to lie, while I do like the soul traits, we have a lot of full stamina damage soul traits. it would be nice to see a bit more low stam options. I would truthfully honest though, I don't really know much about the attack pattern itself, so we have to kind of wing it here. But we'll see how it does go. Right, let's go here. Just take a few hits because we need to, right? We need to get our low stamina. Might as well use our strong attacks though, because I'm pretty sure we are going to get binded. And that's where we're going to die. So there we go. Now we get binded. This is going to take us out. There we go. And now we're at low stamina. 100% last ditch coming in clutch. And with just one strong attack, we are into the second phase. Lovely. We're then going to use our soul bomb. And this time around, we did give weakened defense. So after this, we should be doing around 30% more damage, right? Still love that soul bomb. Now we're doing like 120k per hit. That's actually really good. Pretty much going to breathe through this phase. And remember, if we do die, we now revive at 50%, which is under the 30% threshold. But it shouldn't be too bad, right? Just a few more attacks. Almost there. SA2, there we go, we finished it up. So it took us around close to 2 minutes to do 15 million damage. Depending on the epic raid, that time might change. I did spend more time there trying to get around some of the mechanics. He did do a lot of attacks. And again, we also had to spend around 30 seconds at the start of the quest to get a low stamina. So we disregard around 30 seconds of the fact that we had to get a low stamina, all the dodging we had to do to avoid the attacks. It looks like it takes around a minute at most to do around 15 million damage from Nemu, which honestly isn't too bad. But with that said, lads, that was the video for today, trying out Nemu's new resurrection. I like it. I think she's always been a great character and still holds up quite well, especially with this newfound resurrection. The main thing she did get here was a damage increase, and I like the fact that they kind of experimented with her. Was it the perfect resurrection? I don't think so, but I don't think it's a bad one. I probably would have preferred if they went down the route and just gave her 50% more damage to enemies not affected by an ailment and not be tied behind the fact that you have to be at low stamina, because as of right now, that's still awkward, right? You have to spend the first X amount of time at the start of the quest to get a low stamina. It's not as fluid as full stamina, where you just start at full stamina, and it never has been. I'm not sure if they plan to do more low stam damage characters in the future. If they do, I would like to see them experiment with it more, but I still do like the idea of the skills that they gave her. She got 3 damage increases, right? They're all different. But in honestly, I don't really have much to complain about. I'm quite happy with the outcome. And again, in the gameplay that we did showcase today, she still plays quite smooth, I will say. Might have to try again when the enemies are hollows in IT. Because in all honesty, when going against those human enemies, it wasn't even that bad. It's just a tad bit slow. But again, she doesn't inflict any status damage, so that's kind of expected. Either way though, Nemu fans got a pretty good upgrade. I'm one of you lads. In the comments below, let me know what you lads think about this character's resurrection. And I'll see you lads next time. Take care and peace.